गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टॉपिक ऑफ द डे इज नरेशन और वी कैन से रिपोर्टेड स्पीच और डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस इज द क्वेश्चन बिफोर अस, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डायरेक्ट स्पीच. टू एक्सप्रेस द स्पीकर्स वर्ड्स इन द सेम वे मीन्स व्हेन वी से द स्पीकर्स वर्ड्स इन द सेम वे, स्पीकर के वर्ड्स को सेम वे में कहना, इट इज डायरेक्ट स्पीच. नाउ इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच, टू एक्सप्रेस द स्पीकर्स वर्ड्स इन योर ओन वे, अपने तरीके से कहना, इट इज इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. ओके, एंड नाउ आई हैव रिटन वन सेंटेंस फॉर यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू विल सी दिस डायरेक्ट स्पीच. रवि सेड टू गीता, यू हैव नॉट डन द वर्क टूडे. This is called subject and this is called object, and here it is given the between of subject and object, it is called reporting verb. And you can see here which is given into inverted commas, it is called reported speech. Okay, now how do we change it? RCPTC. In detail we will study later on. According this I am telling you how can we make. Okay, this we will do later on. First reporting verb, reporting verb said to, said to we have done told. Okay, is it clear? According this, R for reporting verb, C for conjunction, P for pronoun, T for tense and C for condition. Okay, first we have to change in reporting verb, said to, told, we have done. Then C for conjunction, we have done that. Is it clear? Next, P for pronoun, she, you is pronoun, and we have to change. How? Rule you know very well, S, O, N, 1, 2, 3. First person according to subject, second person according to object, and third person no change. So according this we have changed. You second person according to object. Object Geeta. That's why she. After that tense. T for tense, tense. In place of this have. You know very well have is the helping verb of present perfect tense. And present perfect tense will go in past perfect tense. So in place of have, had. Not done the work. Now last. It is a condition. That day, today means that day. In place of today, we have written that day because it will be changed into that day. Okay. So once again, according this we do reported speech. Once again, R for reporting verb, so we have changed reporting verb, told. Okay. Then C for conjunction, conjunction we have used that because assertive sentence. Okay. Next, P, P for pronoun. In place of this you, we have written she because second person. According to object, object Geeta is female, that's why she. Next, tense. Tense, it is present perfect tense and it will go in a past perfect tense, that's why had. Not done the work, today condition, then that. Okay, now I will tell you about these all RCPTC, and after doing these I know very well that you will be able to do these all reported speech. Okay, yes, now we will do RCPTC. R for reporting verb. So first of all we will do reporting verb. Reporting verb is changed according to the sentence of reported speech which is given into inverted commas. Okay, so now if sentence is assertive, assertive means positive or negative sentences. Okay, if reporting verb say, then no change. Says, no change. Say to, tell. Says to, tells. Will say, no change. shall say, no change. Will say to, will tell. Shall say to, shall tell. Said, no change. Said to, told. You can see if to is there, then we have changed. And it is changed if sentence is assertive sentence. Okay. And if sentence is interrogative, then if sentence is interrogative, then how do we change in reporting verb? Say, ask, says, ask, say to, ask, says to, ask, will ask, shall ask, will say to, will ask, shall say to, shall ask, said, ask, said to, ask. Means if sentence is interrogative, then in place of these reporting verb, we write these. Okay. And if sentence is imperative, then yes, now we will do in this way. How? If sentence is imperative, in imperative sentences, you know very well, if command is there, order is there, advice is there, suggestion is there, then we do in this way. You can take anyone, as we have taken order, say order. If future tense, then will order, and if past, then ordered. Said to, then also ordered. Mostly it is used, hardly we use these, but we must know. Okay. And if sentence is optative, then in optative sentence it is changed according to this: wish, pray, will wish, will pray, or in past wished or prayed. Mostly these are used. Okay. In optative sentence, if sentence is exclamatory, then if exclamatory sentence, then you can see mostly in past tense. In place of said or said to, we used exclaimed with joy, sorrow, etc. Okay, in this way. And now we will do C for conjunction. Second point we will do now. Yes, now second point of conjunction. How do we change in conjunction? Okay. If sentence is assertive, then that. If sentence is interrogative, and two types. Okay. If yes or no type, then conjunction we use if or whether. Okay. Yes or no type, how? When we get the answer in yes or no. Example I am telling you as have you completed your work? Yes or no. Are you going to market? Yes or no. Will you do your work? Yes or no. Then we use conjunction if or whether. If WH family, then same. As why are you not doing your work? Then conjunction will be same. Why? And what are you doing nowadays? Then conjunction will be what? Means if WH family, then conjunction same. Now imperative. If sentence is imperative, then to, not to, or sometimes that. If sentence is optative, then conjunction that. If sentence is exclamatory, then conjunction that. Okay. And now third, we will do pronoun. Pronoun S-O-N. 1, 2, 3. First person according to subject, second person according to object, and third person no change. Okay. Means S for subject, O for object, and N for no change. In pronouns. Okay. Now next we will do tense. T for tense. Yes, now fourth point we will do tense. How do we change in tense? If simple present tense, it will go in simple past tense. And present continuous tense, past continuous tense. Present perfect tense, past perfect tense. Present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense. And if simple past, then past perfect tense. Past continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense. If past perfect, then no change. past perfect continuous tense, no change. And in future tense, as you know very well, in place of will or shall, we use would or should. Okay, so we have done T4 tense. Now we will do C4 condition. Okay. Yes, now last condition. How do we change in condition? This, that, these, those, here, there, hence, thence, now, then, thus, so, today, that day, yesterday, the previous day, tomorrow, the next day, tonight, that night. Tomorrow, we can say the following day also. Tomorrow, the following day. Ago, before, last month, last week, you know, last night. So, the previous month, the previous night, the previous week, in this way. If next day or next month, then the following day, the following month. In this way, we use this condition. Okay, and now I think this RCPDC we have completed. And first point and first thing which you have to do, you have to revise these all 5 points which I have told you and I have written. So first of all, you will write these all in your FAIR notebook, and in next video we will do the exercise of narration. Okay, goodbye, best of luck.